has an upper endoscopy which confirms a Schadzi ring. Ring is bougie dilated. What should be recommended to prevent a recurrence of a Schadzi ring? What should be recommended to prevent a recurrence? So, is it H2 receptor antagonism? Option A. Is it carafate? Is it proton pump inhibitor therapy? Is it repeat endoscopy with dilation? Please remember, it is the... Yes, what's the answer? Can anybody answer? It is the proton pump inhibitors. Proton pump inhibitor therapy helps to reduce the recurrence of Schadzi ring. Please remember this point. In your NEET super speciality exam, in paper 1, this question will come as a single liner. Which of the following modalities of treatment prevents recurrence of Schadzi ring? Answer should be proton pump inhibitor therapy. Proton pump inhibitor therapy. Right? So this is a diagram of a scan. This is an endoscopic photography of a Schadzi ring. Schadzi ring proper. Alright. If you can see. So this diameter is always... This diameter is always less than 13 mm. 13 mm, right? Next. Next, let us discuss infectious esophagitis. I'll give you one endoscopy image now. Please diagnose what is this endoscopy image. What is this image? What are the findings of this lower esophageal sphincter or lower esophageal endoscopy finding? What are your findings? There are multiple circular constrictions, is it not? Circular constrictions, circular round. You can see multiple circles. This is first important point. Second important point is there is loss of vascularity. There is loss of vascularity here. There is loss of vascularity. You don't find any vascularity here. So this area edema, this area you find edema because of loss of vascularity. This area is edematous. This area is edematous. Can you see? All right, edema, circular constrictions. Is anybody answering? Let us see. Dr. Rakesh. Feline esophagus. Let us see. And multiple esophageal rings are seen, longitudinal furrows. Usually, see, these are the longitudinal furrows, if you can see clearly. Longitudinal furrows, marking the absence of, see, these are longitudinal furrows. When you take a biopsy, you will find more than 15 high power fields containing eosinophils. Now, what's your answer? Eosinophils. What's your answer? Answer is eosinophilic esophagitis. Eosinophilic esophagitis. Eosinophilic esophagitis. Alright. Eosinophilic esophagitis treatment is very difficult. If eosinophilic esophagitis patients are not satisfied with your treatment, they are not at all satisfied. Because locally you cannot give any steroids. Local steroids are less beneficial. Systemic steroids will cause a lot of systemic manifestations. Then other modalities of treatments can be used, but they are very much you will have to also ask the patient to avoid the common allergens. Common allergens like milk, meat, fish, egg, milk protein, dust allergens or something like that. So you'll have to ask the patient to advise, but you find less compliance to treatment. Now let us discuss infections of esophagus. Infections of esophagus. In the figure A, you have got endoscopy showing multiple punched out ulcerations. Here, if you can find, see. Multiple mucosal ulcerations, and with this mucosa is becoming friable. Multiple mucosal ulcerations with friable mucosa, your answer is it is gastroesophageal reflux. Gastroesophageal reflux causing reflux esophagitis. Next comes option B. Next comes, figure B. The figure B has got, you may find shallow ulcers, lot of shallow ulcers, and this person is suffering from HIV. Person is a known case of HIV or some immunocompromised with shallow ulcers. Your answer here should be CMV, cytomegalovirus infection. What is the treatment of choice for cytomegalovirus esophagitis? Let us see who will answer. What is the treatment of choice? What is the treatment of choice for cytomegalovirus esophagitis? So, ganciclovir. But do you have this ganciclovir? Do you think it is... has anybody used ganciclovir in your patient till now? Be honest and tell me. Ganciclovir, is it available in IV formulation or is it available in oral formulation? It is present in IV formulation. Nobody is answering. All right. So if it is available in, yeah, very good. Dr. Rakesh has correctly answered ganciclovir. Ganciclovir, if it is not available or if it is not working or if patient, you cannot give IV injections to the patient for a long time, don't want hospitalization of the patient, then you can go for valganciclovir, which is oral formulation, valganciclovir, or foscarnet. Foscarnet is available in, again, injectable format. Foscarnet is a drug of choice. Alright, ganciclovir is the first drug of choice. If it is not available in the options or you don't want to give it because of no hospitalization and all, already COVID patients are there in my hospital, sir, I don't want to hospitalize this CMV esophagitis patient, then probably go for valganciclovir. Right, next is figure C. In figure C, you find typical shallow ulcerations. These ulcerations, if you closely observe this ulceration, I'll just expand this for you. What do you see? How is this ulcer? This ulcer has a characteristic target lesion type of ulcer, is it not? It's a target lesion. Target lesion type of ulcer. This target lesion type of shallow ulcer is seen in herpes simplex esophagitis. So many patients in your hospital come with herpes simplex virus 1 infection. That is oral herpes. Oral herpes, they come with oropharyngeal ulcerations, small ulcerations. And in our city, in our Hyderabad, they say that fever, in Telugu they say low jwaram undi, or in Urdu they say taab uchli, or fever bukhar uchla. Alright, bukhar bahar aa gaya. So bukhar bahar aana ya low jwaram in Telugu or something like that. They have these ulcerations over the lips or nose. Is it because of fever coming out and affecting, or is it something else? It's HSV infection. Please note, HSV type 1 is very notorious to cause such ulcers even in the esophagus. Patient has chest pain, patient has dysphagia, and burning type of burning sensation or pyrosis, heartburn is there. Then you'll have to manage this case with acyclovir. Acyclovir should be given 400 milligrams 5 times in it. You can go for acyclovir. Valcyclovir can be given slightly, 1 gram orally, TID, something like that you can give. So this is HSV. Here the diagnosis is HSV infection. Next, this is very simple diagnosis. Some UG students are able to answer. UG students are able to answer this. Friable whitish white plaques. White plaques, friable multiple white plaques in an elderly person, malnourished person, diabetic person, pregnant lady, any immunocompromised host. It is candida, esophageal candidiasis. Esophageal candidiasis can be treated by, what is the drug of choice? Fluconazole. But nowadays we are getting lot of cases which are resistant to fluconazole. If fluconazole resistance is found, then you have to go for posaconazole. 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 Alright, if fluconazole resistance is found, right? Or you can go for, in pharmacology textbooks, if you see, they mention that amphotericin can be given orally. Though amphotericin B does not absorb in the GI tract, but locally it acts like a topical agent and it will coat the mucosa and it will cause treatment of fulminant candidiasis of the esophagus. But this is not proved. Alright, this is not, clinical trials have not been in favor of oral amphotericin B for obvious reasons, practically not possible, right? Amphotericin B can be given IV in case of systemic fungal infections or life-threatening fungal infections, right? That we'll discuss later on. In case of candidiasis, what are the associated findings? Associated findings in case of cancer, the candidiasis, please remember, patient will have odynophagia, burning sensation of burning or pain during swallowing. Then patient will have multiple oral ulcers, and maybe patient will have difficulty to put even one small loaf of food in his mouth or her mouth. Alright, and patient is a known case of diabetic. So this is all about infections of the esophagus. Now to conclude the topic, to conclude today's session, I just want to show you this serial images of endoscopy, serial endoscopic images of a very important endoscopic procedure that is becoming popular nowadays. You can easily avoid, the benefit is you can easily avoid a laparoscopic procedure, and this is POEM. What is POEM? Per oral endoscopic myotomy. In case of per oral endoscopy, you can see the lumen of the esophagus, it is very much narrowed because of achalasia. Now you put a balloon dilation. After balloon dilation, under proper anesthesia, what you do is you create a submucosal. You create a, so here you are creating a, so here I'll put an arrow, a submucosal lumen. You are creating a small submucosal lumen. So pocket or submucosal lumen is created so that the solids or liquids, whatever you eat, patient eats, enter into the stomach through a new lumen. Alright, new lumen. Because of gravity, you are not improving the peristalsis, mind you, but because of gravity probably, or because of positioning of the patient, ask the patient to sit and have food at that time, because of gravity, through this lumen he can be able to pass the solids and liquids passively into the stomach and thus avoid progressive loss of weight and dysphagia and other symptoms of achalasia cardia. So with this we conclude today's session, and thank you very much for patiently listening to my class. I would like to conclude with the same points, that our classes will be alternate day, only for 1 hour. Today probably because of excitation of first class, I took a long class maybe, but next class will be short and very precise, and it will be pertaining to paper 1 of NEET super speciality. Every weekend I will be discussing one topic of speciality proper of paper 2. So paper 2 will be discussed in the weekends, paper 1 will be discussed alternate day for 1 hour with approximately 20 questions. 20 question and answer discussions will be done, and we are not going to leave any stone unturned. Yeah, in the end I'll also give you certain tips, how to quickly answer the questions, how to pick up the right within the question, picking up in between the lines and coming to a particular diagnosis, right? So any queries, you can you are free to mail us, you are free to chat with us in this lockdown period, and thank you very much for patiently listening. Bye.